And apples have become the latest victim of the worsening relationship between Taiwan and China. China recently announced an indefinite ban on imports of the fruit from Taiwan, saying that harmful pests had been detected in recent shipments, which could threaten China's agriculture. Taiwan, which China claims as its own territory, has said there is nothing wrong with its pineapples and called the ban a political move by China aimed at further pressurizing the island to accept Chinese rule. China has denied the accusations that the ban is about politics, saying it was purely a matter of biosecurity. The Taiwan authorities have been urging the citizens and international allies to consume the pineapples in support of the domestic industry. The government has also been asking Taiwanese companies to make bulk purchases and looking for alternative export markets. Pineapples reportedly make up about 40% of Taiwan's total fruit exports, of which 90% go to China. Offering a defiant rebuke to Beijing, Taiwanese President Tsai Ing-wen has said that her country will not be beaten by China's ban and will rally around its farmers to turn the crisis into an opportunity. She called on the people to eat more pineapples to help the farmers, saying Taiwan had been ambushed, quote-unquote, by the ban. Tsai Ing-wen also said, since the time China announced the ban, orders for more than 41,000 metric tons of pineapples have been coming in, including 5,000 metric tons from Japan. Taiwan says it is heartened by the support from the United States and Canada. Canada extended its support, with the Canadian Trade Office posting an image of workers around a pineapple pizza, along with the hashtag Freedom Pineapples. The picture's caption stated that its workers have been consuming the pineapples from Taiwan, adding that the idea to put pineapples on a pizza was invented by a Canadian. The American Institute in Taiwan, under the hashtags Real Friendship and Real Friends, Real Progress, posted pictures of pineapples on their Taipei premises. While neither the U.S. nor Canada have formal diplomatic ties with Taiwan, both have their own disputes with Beijing over human rights, trade and other issues. Local politicians, meanwhile, are posting pictures of themselves in fields with the farmers and encouraging domestic consumers as well as other countries to pick up the slack left by China. China has in recent months ramped up pressure to get Taiwan to accept Chinese sovereignty. Beijing has regularly been carrying out military drills close to Taiwan-controlled islands in the disputed South China Sea.